Hello, brothers and sisters. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. If it's your first time you come across Atalo YouTube channel, please don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and like our video. Don't also forget to turn on the notification bell so that anytime we drop a new video, you can be notified. Thank you very much. To my returning subscriber, thank you also. God will bless you people. Thanks. Atalo, 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 we move. Today is a great day. All this bandit issue, you people will go one after the other. There is a leader, bandit leader from Zamfara State. Today, the cop don't fool. That is why I say, let me come and share the news with you people. This is the man you are seeing there on the picture. You see, it? This very man. This man has been terrorizing Zamfara State. This is the notice after he has been key. That is why I will read it. I will read most of them for you, so that you also can go through other book. Thank you very much. Let me read. A Zamfara notorious bandit key in clash with rival group. Know this bandit is a popular bandit in Zamfara State, including Nigeria. The government even declared him amnesty program, but he had no career. Someone that was found with almost 20 AK-47. Let me read so that you people will listen. Thank you. Those who live by the sword die by the sword goes a popular saying that turns out to be story of Awa Daudawa, a bandit leader that returned to his vomit after he presumably turn a new life. His notorious as a criminal and one of the leaders of deadly leaders of bandits that have been dishing out sorrows to the people of Northwest became known after he organized the adoption of 300 students from government secondary school, Kankara, Katsina State. This was the bandit that adopted almost 300 students from Kankara State. If you people can still remember. Daudawa was reportedly key Friday night, just 4 days after he returned to the underworld. He was leading a revenge mission in the heart of Dumburu Forest, a vast jungle stretch between Zumi local government in Zamfara State and Besari local government of Katsina State. When a rival bullet brought him down, two months after his despicable role in Kankara, the bandit appeared in Gasau, capital of Zamfara, along with five of his men. where he announced his repentance and hand over 20 AK rifle and other weapon to the police. He thereafter became a beneficiary of the state amnesty program. He was benefiting from the program, from amnesty program. You see, on Thursday, it was reported that Dawa returned to the stretches after he vacated his new abode in Damba, the outskirts of Gasau. It was gathered that Dawa was killed while leading his men on a revenge attack on boys loyal to another bandit called Bilolo. It was gathered that while Dawa was in Gasau following his repentance, some armed members of the Balolo camp attacked the position of his men in an attempt to rustle their cattle. Now go die because of cattle. Now never see. Killing two of Dawa gang member in the process. Dawa was said to have vowed to retaliate. A source told Messman that while Dadawa's gang succeeded in killing some person in the opposition gang, their leader was gunned down by Balolo's boys. Confirm the story. Zamfara Commissioner for Security and Home Affairs, Abubakar Dwara, said Dadawa was killed after he murdered somebody and rustled his cattle. After he swore by the Quran never to go back to his old ways. This Dadawa was the one that swore by the Quran that he will never go back to his way. That was why they grant him an amnesty program. This same Dadawa now is trying to attack other gang for revenge, and it lead to his death. You see, God don't catch this one. To go back, he heard that he went back under the guise of going to attend wedding of his relative, but he instead resumed his illegal activity. He not deceived those people because he swore by the Quran. And he's going to attend one of the wedding relative, of his relative. But unfortunately, this guy, he went back to resume his criminal activities. Let's continue. We heard that he killed someone and attempted to rustle his cattle, but the other people in the forest rose up to him and killed him in the process, he said. That was how he died. Other gang now rush out to make sure that they end his life. God don't strike this one. Now so, all of una, we say Nigeria, we not go live without bandits. Una will be bandits so. Una go they fight una self. We go kill each other. And there must be peace in that country. No matter you people like it or not, that is why we decide to share Nigeria. When we share the Nigeria, if you are going to govern your bandits area, you can go on with it. Insecurity has become a major issue in almost every part of the country for some time. Insecurity is not sometime in Nigeria. He has been one of the major problems we are facing. That is why we are deciding for Buhari to resign. Buhari need to resign to put an end into all this banditry and this terrorism group in Nigeria. That is the little I came to give. Thank you very much. May God bless you all. All my viewers, wherever you are, I wish you people a happy weekend. Bye. See you next time. Bye.